HaKadosh Baruch Hu saw that Avram, when he started out his career, is going to raise up a family that's exceptional in this midah. And he said, Ki yedati, I know Avram, I know. V'man asher yitzave esbono v'esbeisei achara. He's going to command his family, his children after him. V'shamu derech Hashem, he'll keep the way of Hashem. That's why I have chosen this man. Avram is very great. Avram had many madregas of shlemus. He could have been chosen for whatever it is. But here Hashem said, why do I know him? Why is my mind on him? Because I know he's going to make it his business that his children will forever and ever keep the way of Hashem. That's why I love this man, Yedati. And the Emunah says on that, Gimel Azim Hay, there are three stubborn creatures in the world. Gimel Azim, three strong, stubborn creatures in the world. Yisrael, Gomes, the Jews are stubborn among the nations. Tanagol Bavis, the rooster, is stubborn among the birds. And Kela Bahayas, and the dog is stubborn among animals. Early in the morning, everybody's still asleep, it's still dark. But the rooster is crowing. He said, wake up, wake up. Nobody wants to wake up. They wanted to keep quiet. But Baruch HaShanosan HaSech Levin, Hashem made an alarm clock. And that's what it's saying. Imdu L'Avidus Hashem, wake up, L'Avidus Hashem. Nobody wants to listen to him. The farmer opened up the window and throws a shoe at him. But he continues. Doesn't stop. It's his nature. He's an ass. He's stubborn. Of course, it's not Bechira. But our Kodesh Baruch is giving us an example. That's how we have to be. We don't care what the world says. The world can say whatever they say, all the colleges, all the newspapers, all the books. We say, Bereishis Borel, Lekimes HaShamayim HaSoares. And we'll continue to announce that to the world forever and ever. And the second is the Kelev Bachayas. A dog is loyal to his master. A dog, once he gets a master, is loyal to his master. He'll bite other people, he'll bark at other people. He comes up to his master and licks his feet and he tries to make himself beloved by his master. Everybody knows the famous story of a dog who used to go every day at 6 o'clock to meet the train where his master came from the city where he worked. So the dog came to the train station to be mekabel upon him his master. He came every day without fail. One day the master didn't get off the train and the dog was watching. Didn't know what to do, so the dog didn't go home. And he slept in the train yard waiting for his master. He never went home again. And the people in the treasure had pity on him, and they fed him there. That dog remained day after day, week after week, waiting for his master to come. Until finally he died, and they buried him in the train yard. As an example of a Ne'amah. He's a Talibah. And so we too, I call this boy said, Merche Hastir, Astir, Esponai, Mikem, I'll hide my face from you. He doesn't show himself as openly as he did in the days of old, which to us makes no difference. We still are just as aware of Hashem, and we still shout Hashem Echad, just as with Moshe Rabbeinu's time. When they saw the Alan Yaakovit and they ate the man that fell in Hashemayim. We don't change forever and ever. Who is Shemaine Barach and Avishainis until finally Hashem will speak once more to us. As he spoke on Har Sinai. We are loyal people. As Dibul Azik, that's why our Kodesh Borei Shulta, he soiled us. We are stubborn among the nations. And that is a meaning we have to continue to nourish. We have to try to become more and more stubborn, not only in general to remain from Jews, stubborn against everything that comes in from the outside world. We don't care what the Goyim do. We don't care what the styles of the Goyim are. We are going to do what we're supposed to do according to our way, and we are going to ridicule. We're going to laugh at Duma Sa'ila. Kol Etzanusa Asira, all that son is this also, Baal Meir, son is David Azar, and we ridicule David Azar. We laugh at them, and we maintain that we are the ones that have the only truth in the world, which is of course so. Now this midah of stubbornness, of course, can be misused. A person is stubborn just because he wants to be stubborn of himself. My Kodesh Baruch doesn't praise that. But it takes that midah which is put into him by our Kodesh Baruch for that purpose. Or the king also saw the Yosha. All midas that a person has were made by Hashem. So stubbornness was made just for that purpose. Via action. Atem advekim Hashem alekeh. Now the Torah tells us a number of examples of people who prospered because of this midah. When Hashem said to Avraham Avinu, Lech Lecha, it was a very difficult thing. In those days, it wasn't like going today. You want to move, let's say, to England, any place. So, there's airplanes, come to England, you'll find some other Jews, you'll find real estate people, you'll find an apartment for you, a house, little place, it wasn't like that. If you left your home, you were mamish like a naked little baby. You came among other nations. Anybody who wanted could take you and make a slave out of you. And the courts of the judges among the goyim didn't have any rachmanis on strangers. A stranger came to town, anybody could do what he wanted with him. It was very dangerous to leave your family. The only protection you had was to stick with your family. Hashem said, I don't let her get going. So Avraham got up and he went. With the greatness of Avraham, don't think of the small thing, the big Nisayon left with her. Very big Nisayon. Avraham could have said, yes, obey the Shalom, I'll go the next year. But as soon as he had the tzivui, he got up and he went. What about Parnassim? Where's his bodyguard? Nothing. He doesn't care. He went. Avraham was a very great man. He cares very. He recognized his creator when he was a little boy, Ben Gibel Shonin. And later said Ben Alboim Shonin. He cares very. But he became even greater and greater. Avraham was a man who, with his own seichel, he saw a Kodesh Baruch in the world. He studied the Shah Rabbechina, but the famous Halavis brings as an example, and he became extremely great, as if he was actually seeing Hashem in the world. All right. Well, they said that love went with him. That was an exceptional thing. Love went with him. Who didn't have to go with him? Why did love go with him? But Lot was loyal to Avraham. He was his rabbi. He said, where my rabbi goes, I'm going to go too. It's a tremendous thing. Don't think of this whole thing. We're accustomed to downplaying Lot. He's nobody. Not everybody. You should know that Lot was chosen to be the Zayde on the mother's side of Mashiach. see that comes from a load. Now, Lot was successful because of that. The gamla Lot, ha'hoileh es alom, or yotzeh u'boker el. He started out with nothing. He ended up becoming a very wealthy man. Lot became very wealthy. Why? The gamla Lot, ha'hoileh es alom, because he went with alom. Hashem was encouraging him to carry him. Boy, he said, I love you for your loyalty to alom. The double great Hachomen. That's a voice syndrome. Only, Lot also made an error. There came a time, by Yisa Lot Mikedem. Lot traveled away Mikedem. Because when they Shalewa, he left HaKodesh Baruch. Now, Lot didn't forsake HaKodesh Baruch. Lot was not ever the way there's ever. Didn't worship idols. But Lot forsook Avram, and that's considered forsaking Hashem. To forsake your Rebbe wasn't comfortable. You know how Avram lived in a tent all his life? So you have to live in a tent, you have no bathroom. You have to live in a tent. You have to make a hole in the ground in your tent and then cover it up with dirt. And that's just a pleasant aura to have a bathroom in the floor of your tent. Where did you sleep? When it rained, the ground was wet. Very uncomfortable to live in a tent. Avraham never had lived in a house. Always in a tent. So Lot, after a while, decided, it's not a life. He wants to live in a house. And in Sodom, there were houses. And in Sodom, he had a house. So he went to Sodom and bought a house. He became a Baal HaBayis there. I have nothing to do with the people of Sodom. They're no good. But I have to live in it. I have to live. They live in Sodom. And now Lot forsook HaKodesh Baruch Hu. That's what the Medrash says. Ayisa Lot Mikedem, Nosa Mikadmoy Neshalevam, you forsook your Rebbe. No matter how difficult it was, no matter how great are your possessions, that you have to have more land in order to pasture your sheep and your herds. No test, nothing will help. You should remain with your Rebbe despite everything. And that's why Lot finally got lost. Almost entirely. Almost entirely. Only Lot's two daughters were saved by HaKadosh Baruch Hu for a certain purpose. Eshtei b'noseha ha-nimtsoi, your two daughters that are found. So the Gemara says, what's called you are found? You're found by Hashem. I found the two daughters of stone, of Lot and stone. It says, motsosi es David, Avdi, I found my servant David. Now the plain meaning is David was a shepherd boy. When Shmuel HaNavi came to choose a melech, to anoint him as a melech, so Yishai brought out all of his sons. But after HaKadosh Baruch Hu told Shmuel that I have rejected this one, I reject this one, I reject this one, so then Shmuel said, I have no more sons. I have a son, the little boy, he's behind the sheep, takes care of the sheep. Hashem took me from behind the sheep, and he was chosen. So Motsos, I found David, my son. I found him there.
Thank you.
machines, write them now on slips of paper on the shulchan, and hand them out here. Instead of asking me the questions later, personally, write them out, but make it short and clear. Short and clear on slips of paper, and pass them up here. On the pasuk Motzosi David Avni, I found my servant David. So the Chachamim say, Heichon Motzosi, where did I find him? I found him in Zdom. Eshtei b'nei Yosefa ha'Mitzoy, she had two daughters out of town. Now this was a reward for Lot. He doesn't deny the reward to anybody. And even though Lot later had surrendered his loyalty, but for the previous actions of forsaking his home. So how do you chesed nuraya, Hashem said, remember the chesed of your young days. Lechtech Achla, you went after me, you followed your Rebbe Avram. I'll remember you, and therefore, Lot was given the very great schus, that from him came Mashiach ben David. Another example where received a great reward for loyalty. In the case of Hagar, when Hagar became pregnant, so she showed signs of arrogance towards Sarah. Sarah was childless. Now Sarah saw a great sakana at that house, because the main spirit of that Beis HaMikdash was Sarah. And he said, Lokorosi the Ishti Ishti Beisi Beisi, and the Ishti Beisi, the woman, the idealistic woman, that's the spirit of the house. Avram was busy outside also. The house was only one part of his activities. But Sarah concentrated her life in her house. And her house became a Beis HaMikdash. Beis HaMikdash Mamish. And when she saw Yishmael was laughing, don't laugh in the Beis HaMikdash. So she said, he said, Gosh, he can't be here anymore. That's how strict she was. Sophia Halichas Beisa, she watched carefully what went on in the house. Somebody was laughing about Tera, and she saw Yishmael Mesafe. Oh, laughing time he ended how it's finished. And so, Hagar, when she was pregnant with Ishmael, and she became arrogant, so Sarah was thinking, what's going to happen to this house now? She's going to try to become now the mother of the army Israel. She'll have children. I'll be the barren woman. I'll be shoved aside. What will happen to our base on English? Hagar, even if she's a fine woman, but she's not capable of being the high priest, the Kohen Gadol of this house. And so Sarah chastised Hagar. How did she chastise her? Some say, I heard this from Adam Gadol, that when Sarah used to talk to the women, Sarah Mikayega says, I know she spoke to the women, she said, Shmuesen. Who said Shmuesen to the women? So when she finished, Hagar had the privilege of talking it over with all the women. In Musa Yeshivas, after the Rebbe said the Musa Shmuis, so then there were Ebel Zagas in the corners. Each one, there were some were more expert, so they used to have more boys around them, and he spoke over the Shmuis. So Hagar was a leader in repeating, talking over Sarah Shmuis. But now, when Sarah saw that Hagar was becoming conceited, so she took away that privilege from her. She didn't let her repeat anymore. When Hagar heard that she's not going to be a repeater of the Shmuesen, it was called the Enoch. I'd say, Sarah afflicted her as an Enoch. That's what all happened. So she's able to repeat Sarah Shmuesen. And so she ran away. When she ran away in a midbar, he said, Ayim Samal, Hashem Amalek found her. And Amalek said to her, Hagar, Simcha Shai, you should know who you are. You're Talmid of Sarai. How can you forsake your Rebbe Sarai? So like I said, look what my Rebbe did to me. She took away my privilege of repeating the Shmuesen. So the Amalek said, where are you going? Going to some better place. Shuel Gryota, go back to your Rebbe. His son ain't Tachas Yodah. And then you shall be afflicted by her. No matter what she says and does to you, she's still your Rebbe. To be loyal to her. And because Hagar accepted that, and she went back, Hagar had a very great schutz. But HaKadosh Baruch Hu said that Yishmael is going to be a very, very numerous nation. A great nation came out of Hagar. Now beside the shlemas that she had when she continued for some time with Sarah, until finally she left, but she became the mother of a great nation. You have to know that the Mohammedans, according to the Psalm of the Rama, are not Oyvde Avedi Zorah. They're Toyah. They're all in error, but they're against idolatry. It's a very big thing. And we have to know that they have among them a great deal of sneers. The fact that the women cover their faces with veils is not a small thing. Of course, the Arabs are stupid mizima, very immoral people. But still, compared to other nations, they are models. I was once looking in a guidebook of homosexuals, If you travel, watch out, don't go into the Arabian lands for the take off your head. In Israel, you can go this way. Israel is safe. But in the Arabian lands, they take off your head. That's a big schus for Hagar, the mother of Ishmael. for it. She was rewarded too for her loyalty. And the Malach is teaching us, Hoga Simcha Shala, you remember, you're a Simcha, you're the Tami Yisrael. Now, when you follow this principle, you'll see that everywhere there's a reward for the Nemanim, for people who have to meet their Nemanim. It's a preparation for their great degree, great madrege, of coming Dovik to Hashem in Olam Haba. Of course, if you're Dovik to your Rebbe, after a while, you'll be Dovik more than the Rebbe alone. We have to know Dovik to your Rebbe is so important that HaKadosh Baruch Hu considers it right away Ugo Sin, what is clinging to Hashem. So whether your Rebbe is a Bobeba or a Satma or a Lakewada, be loyal to your Rebbe. Stick to your Rebbe, for that's called clinging to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's how important that is. Ugo to Hashem Sinbo. Actually, HaKadosh Baruch Hu considers it as if you're joined to HaKadosh Baruch Hu directly. And now we come to one more form of Dreikus. And that is to be loyal to your people, to be loyal to the Am Yisrael. What does that mean? Let's say you're a Frum Jew. When you look down on big groups of other Frum Jews. As I say, a woman in Virginia was once visiting and she called me up. She was an Orthodox woman. And she was talking against the Jews of Borough Park. And the Jews of Borough Park have programs, illegal things. I said, what are you talking about? Jews of Borough Park? When I walk in Borough Park, really, I walk in Borough Park, I'm walking on Moskovich. Mamish Atmos Kodesh. Blocks and blocks and blocks. All the Shem and Mitzvahs, every single one of them. No question, I have Amma Yisrael Kodesh Baruch Hu loves them. Where else will you find that Kodesh Baruch Hu Shechina among Frum Jews? Frum Jews in every detail of their lives, they make high in everything. How can you say such a thing? Besides, the Gaon and Tzaddikim also in Borough Park. Hasidim, very many holy people in Borough Park. But even the Hamline are from people. How can you say that? But the man used to come here every Thursday night. You heard me say this? He stopped coming. He was angry. When you talk against Borough Park, you're not big colors, I said. You can't talk against from Jews. And therefore, HaKadosh Baruch Hu said you have to be Nem unto your people. Now you have to know, when it says, Kol Yisrael Yeshlem Chelek Leilam Habo, it doesn't mean that you are worthy of Leilam Habo. No. You wouldn't get Leilam Habo on your own merits. It's only because you're a Chelek of Kol Yisrael. It's because you are a part of Am Yisrael, HaKadosh Baruch Hu promised it wholesale to the Klal Yisrael. And only as much as we feel united with them, in that meter, in that measure, will we be zeichet to what they're zeichet. HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to Avraham Avinu, Al tir Avraham, don't be afraid. Tzchor ho halvei me'oi. Your reward is very great. Not halvei, but halvei me'oi. That's all it matters. And only the shechar of the others that we have Olam Haba. So we have to be loyal to our others. Of course, we have to give names after our others. After all the tradition of our nation, Sadiqa, and we have